Time or space to make a play, a little tip and quality chance for him.
DeLeo with some speed drives it through in for LePon. LePon gets bumped into the boards and another penalty, and now LePon taking exception, and here we go. Kara and LePon.
Well, this all initiated off the forecheck from LePon, who's a guy that had 129 penalty minutes in the American League last year with the Moose. A nice job getting on the forecheck, drawing the initial penalty, and he's into a fairly even bout with a much larger Jujhar Khaira.
Lions been waiting for the opportunity to come in, and now they will. So Khaira was getting the initial call. We'll see whether or not things get evened out.
Well, a nice job by LePon, former Western Hockey Leaguer and former Kamloops Blazer last year, 71 games with the Moose. Total 30 points and 129 penalty minutes. Here he gets to the puck first, takes a hit to make a play, and there's the penalty and interference on Khaira, and there's the retaliation. I got a feeling it will be evened up. Khaira coming off of an offseason where he signed his first one-way ticket, a two-year deal with the Edmonton Oilers last year.
To the backboard, Sherratt, tight turns. Sherratt ahead for Kopp, and Kopp on for Brandon Tanev. 9 seconds of the opening period, Tanev takes it wide. And a penalty coming up. The back referee makes the call. And now we've got a pileup going on as LePon is in there, Gazdik is in there. Dustin Byfuglien is in there.
This is all about Tanev's speed, trying to get wide, and then was hauled down to the ice. Lomberg won't let go of Byfuglien as Gazdik is there as well. Byfuglien might be able to take them both on. You know, Gazdik, though, he can look at this. He's trying to get across the linesman, who's telling him that's enough, and now we got a fight here. LePon's dropped the gloves with Lomberg.
Jason LePon and Lomberg. Ooh, boy, they each landed a couple of right hands. They gave and they took. Swinging left by LePon that missed. And down to the ice they go.
LePon caught the eye. Maurice had a fight in the Oilers game against Khaira. And this one spills over after the initial call against Valimaki. Pushing and shoving, and then these two separate. That's Lomberg and LePon. Dustin Byfuglien losing some of his equipment. Maurice wants a better explanation why this happened after the whistle and after the linesman had some guys. So Tanev with the speed, going down the right side, and he's thrown into the boards. That's the initial call. And after LePon came and just brushed into Valimaki, everybody grabs a partner. And then Lomberg, who's right in there, we'll see him disappear after he's tied up with Byfuglien. Finds LePon, those two engage. Lomberg still hasn't let go. And then once he got together with LePon, those two tagged each other with some heavy ones. Got down, got back up.
Get the feeling Byfuglien came in there because Luke Gazdik was in there. Gazdik is certainly one of the tougher players in the National Hockey League. Dustin Byfuglien flips it up as Gazdik takes a run at Byfuglien as those two come together again. And now Byfuglien takes a run at Kulak. And here we go. Byfuglien and Gazdik have the gloves off. This started in the opening period as Byfuglien takes Gazdik to the ice.
Saw the history back a couple of seasons ago. It was bubbling at the end of the first. Gazdik, I'm sure he can still be physical and an asset to a hockey team. Byfuglien relents and decides, okay, I guess the only way to have you back off is to take care of him with my fists. Byfuglien a good hit, the neutral zone. And of course, Gazdik then is going to come and see if he can engage him. Previously was the hit from Byfuglien on Gazdik. Shot to the head with that cross check from Gazdik saying, I'm in the lineup, I'm on the ice, so we're going to do this.
Lomberg and Enstrom had a bit of a battle going, and then good hit by Bufflin just outside the blue line, and in comes Gazdik, and they'll head to the penalty box. The Flames do get the extra minor penalty. A couple of years with Vancouver, a couple of years with Carolina for Eddie Lack. Jacob Truba steps into the ribbon, and Truba's going to get a penalty, and that brings in Hathaway. And down they go, and Rivik is slow to get up. In fact, is yet to get up.
This was after Rivik dumped the puck in. And Truba continued through with his hit. I just made the comment, the Flames are trying to get physical. Truba, it's a little high and a little late. And Rivik is still being attended to on his knees in the Jets zone. Truba down the tunnel, halfway to the penalty box, and see if this is considered a hit to the head or interference. Might even be a major.
Veteran Brad Watson, the referee.
Explaining right now to Wheeler and Monahan exactly how he saw the play unfold, as we see Rivik, the Slovakian, head to the dressing room. Hathaway sits beside Gazdik in the penalty box. Gazdik's been there since late second period. A dust up with Dustin Bufflin.
Didn't quite make it to Thomas Greiss. Hickey gets back to his feet as Scott Mayfield plays it up the wall. Kept in by Rooney. Gloves are off. Mayfield and Thompson. And a stick wrapped up in the middle, trying to get a little bit of separation.
Well, we don't see this too often, Butchie, but it's preseason, and Ben Thompson, a pretty rugged, physical player, played Albany last year, had a few games up in New Jersey, tough kid. We know Mayfield's a big boy, and Thompson trying to make his presence felt.
I'm sure this is not the first time these two guys have met. So, yeah, you're trying to make an impression, too, on your coaching and your coaches and, of course, the organization. So it's a part of their game, and, you know, hey, let's get it out of the way. And these two guys square up, and away they go. There's a quick check, and Thompson's coming in at Mayfield. And you know right away, they're talking to one another and say, hey, you want to go? Look at, there's the whisper in the ear. You never did that, did you, Kenny? I know I didn't.
Hey, look, like you saw Ben Thompson maybe initiate a little bit, wanted to get something going for the Devils, gets a couple of less there. No damage done from other guys. Two big boys that can handle themselves. And for me, I know it's not as big a part of the game, but every once in a while, you like to see that spark. And this is two guys that I agree with you, Butch. I think they've done this before in the American Hockey League.
Well, he takes a hit to make the play. That was Farnham ramming into him. And now the Rangers look to move up the ice. Big hit there. Sam Moran introduces himself to Gabriel Fontaine, and now Moran will drop the gloves. Thought that this might happen, Farnham and Moran, and they are going. Big size advantage from Moran. He gets the right arm free. Farnham knows how to throw him, but he's at a disadvantage here. Moran mauling him. And Moran will take him down. Elizabeth will jump in. That's 6-7, 2-27 against 5-10, 190 in Big One. Let's go inside the glass for the first time.
Al Theodore to move it up ahead. Real good camp for Thomas Hika. He'll play it in. Nosek with a good hit along the boards. And now England's going to jump in. There was McDermott that put the hit on Nosek. And England took exception to it.
Now McDermott's got some size. 6'5", 208. And of course the veteran Derek England, no stranger to this situation.
McDermott trying to get the right loose. Both players trying to get their arms free. It's not always easy to do.
McDermott took a little bit of a run at Nosek, and England just came in to stick up for his teammate, and these two big men are going to go at it. That is tiring, trying to get those arms in.
That's going
to
be an exhausting exercise.
Not much landed in the situation that both these guys are knowing what they're doing. And so look at McDermott. Played Ontario Reign last year, had 135 penalty minutes there for the 23-year-old. He's the one who took a little bit of a run here at Nosek and caught the right leg, Thomas Nosek, and England just kind of
Right after him, a quick conversation, and the gloves come off.
So Derek Englund and Curtis McDermott drop the gloves. And fighting majors.